Hi, my name is Joe Cirillo, and I'm in Electrical Occupations. Today we're going to talk about wire sizing, Ohm's law, and how to find the correct equation for when you're sizing wire for your household appliances. First thing I want to talk to you about is Ohm's law itself. It is always a three-variable algebraic equation. The three main parts of it are going to be volts, power, and current. In this case, we're going to take the nameplate on the back of an appliance, which is states what the power that this appliance, particular whatever it may be, takes up in watts. So we're going to take the power divided by the volts is going to give you the current. And right here I have is a simplified form of it. The C is going to give you the answer of current in amps. So as we talked about, it is a three-variable algebraic equation. Two values are always known when calculating wire size. So you're always going to know the power of what the appliance takes up in watts and the volts supplied. So let's say you're talking about a range that might take up 500 watts of power and it's a 240 volt circuit. So you would take the power divided by the volts and it's going to give you your current. As I said before, the current is going to give you your answer in amperes. The variable that is always known, that is unknown, is the current, which is represented as C. The known variables, as I said before, are power in watts and the volts supplied. When the answer to the equation is found, it will be in amps. You're going to use the chart below, which is found in the National Electric Code, which is basically the same thing I have here simplified down. So let's say you're doing a lighting circuit in your house. When you do that equation, and if you find out that, let's say, it draws only 4 or 5 amps, you would use a 15 amp breaker, then you would use 14 gauge wire. Each of these and the size of wire used in this column corresponds to which breaker you would use with it. So when you find out that, let's say, your microwave requires a lot more power, you find out in the equation that it takes up 20 amps, you're going to use a 20 amp breaker in your panel in your basement, and you're going to use 12 gauge wire. As well as your electric dryer is going to take a little bit more. Gas ranges are completely different. You're going to use a 30 amp breaker with 10 gauge wire. Central air units, the giant things outside your house, as well as your stoves, require a lot of power because of the heating and cooling elements inside of the device. You're going to use a 40 amp breaker with 8 gauge wire.